There was nothing about the starry sky that night to suggest that strange and mysterious things would soon be happening. As unsuspecting muggles slept, a huge motorbike with a giant astride it tumbled down from the darkness. The giant, named Hagrid, left a blanket-wrapped bundle on the doorstep of number 4 Privet Drive. Nestled in the bundle was a baby. Harry Potter.
Yeah, that's the boy who lived. So much.
For the next 11 years, Harry lived with his dreadful step-parents, the Dursleys. Until that fateful day, when he received the letter inviting him to attend Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry. Hagrid took Harry to Diagon Alley to purchase a most unusual list of school supplies. While at Gringotts Wizard Bank, Hagrid collected a scruffy package from Vault 713, mentioning to Harry that the package, whatever it was, would be safer at Hogwarts. Soon after, Harry caught the Hogwarts Express from platform 9 3/4 and left the Muggle world far behind. Dumbledore stood up. This term, the corridor on the third floor is out of bounds to everyone who does not wish to suffer a most painful death. Harry sat beneath a sorting hat, hoping that he would not be chosen for Slytherin House over Gryffindor. Not Slytherin, eh? Said the hat in his ear. You could be great. It's all here in your head, and Slytherin will help you on your way to greatness. No? Well, if you're sure, better be... Gryffindor!
Welcome to Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry. I am Albus Dumbledore, your headmaster. Now, Hogwarts is full of secrets, Harry, so search behind every door. But keep in mind, not all secrets are rewarding. Only this morning, I took a wrong turn
right now, for your world record,
stumbled upon a room full of chocolate frogs. But alas, when I returned, they'd been replaced by a nasty horde of fire crabs. Now, up the stairs and off to your lessons. Don't be late. Your first lesson is upstairs on the third floor, Mr. Potter.
Hey, Harry! Remember me, Ron Weasley? My brothers, Fred and George, have something to show you. Follow me!
Real world record. Yep.
Follow me, Harry!
I could have beat you. Hello.
Hello, Harry. We can show you how to get around Hogwarts. First year, you have a lot to learn. Follow us for a secret lesson.
I'll see you later in Defense Against the Dark Arts class. Good luck, Harry.
Fucking stupid, man. Who am I run like in the most stupid place? I hate when I do this shit.
We're going to teach you how to climb. Run to the bookcase and don't stop. You'll climb up. Above the bookcase is a Bertie Bott's Every Flavor Bean. Collect all the beans you can find and meet us in the next room. Well done. Now, let's try jumping. Run to the ledge, then press the jump button to jump across. If you fall down, you can climb back up and start over. It's in the next room. We'll take the shortcut and meet you there.
Why, it's Pottywee Potter!
That's Peeves the Poltergeist.
Still, not that bad. Could do worse. So watch your step. Could be much worse than that.
Thanks, Harry. We need the beans for some experiments. Here's a wizard card for you. You've earned it.
That's a gold.
Well, well, well. If it isn't the famous Harry Potter. I'm Draco Malfoy, and you do well to show me respect.
These are my fellow Slytherins, Crabbe and Goyle. Naturally, we Slytherins are going to win the House Cup and the Quidditch Cup.
And that's a good
you
goal.
Better stay out of our way, Potter. Let's go, boys.
Professor Quirrell. Today we'll learn how to protect ourselves against dark magic with the Flipendo spell. This is the symbol for the Flipendo spell. Now hold down the mouse button, make the same pattern, and then let go of the button.
Pretty fucking terrible.
That was a shaky effort, Mr. Potter.
Oh, that was a shaky effort.
To do
for sure.
Practice. 5 points for Gryffindor. Go on, Mr. Potter. Try again. That's not the shape I expected, Mr. Potter.
Wow, you could have set a worse line than that, couldn't you?
Splendid! You may now enter the Flipendo Challenge to practice the spell. Follow me, Mr. Potter. Hold down the mouse button to aim the Flipendo spell. Release the button to cast the spell. Try it on that barrel.
Flipendo!
Cast your Flipendo spell at the switch on the wall to open the door. Flipendo affects all sorts of things, such as this cauldron. Knock it over, Mr. Potter.
Flipendo! Flipendo! No!
Well done.
Damn, that was good.
Go on,
oh, that's smooth.
Collect your challenge stars. I'll meet you further on.
Hello, Harry Potter. I am nearly headless Nick, the Gryffindor House Ghost. Now, this is a save game book. When you touch it, your game will automatically be saved. The game will restart from this point if you faint. You can also load a saved game from the main menu. Goodbye.
Cast your Flipendo spell on this block to knock it out of the way.
No! No! No!
Ah.
This is a gnome, Mr. Potter.
Hopefully I can actually get a good...
Knock him on his backside to complete the challenge. They move quickly and can be quite a nuisance.
Nintendo! Nintendo!
Congratulations, Mr. Potter. You completed the challenge. You collected the required number of challenge stars. 5 points for Gryffindor. Now, get to broomstick practice before you're late.
Back in their Gryffindor common room, Harry, Ron and Hermione talked about their exciting first days at Hogwarts. There was much talk about the break-in at Gringotts Wizard Bank. But there was little time to dwell on this, since Harry and his friends were expected at their flying lesson with Madame Hooch.
Okay.
I am your instructor, Madame Hooch. For your first lesson, you will fly through these magic rings.
Save all this shit, like.
And with the direction keys. And slow down keys adjust your flight speed. Ready, Potter? On my whistle, then. Well done, Mr. Potter. Now let's see how you do with smaller rings. bit of height. These rings should challenge you.
No, how did I miss that one?
Always keep an eye on the next trick. Let's try it with moving rings. I believe you have a natural talent for this.
No, how did I miss that? Oh, for fuck's sake.
Well done, Mr. Potter. Perfect score. 20 points for Gryffindor. I also congratulate you for being the first student to find the secret room since 1867. From now on, you may practice flying at any time. You will find the option on the main menu.
Fucking shit is split.
Time for your charms lesson now. Good day, Mr. Potter.
Listen, Harry, but I'll teach you a new spell I've learnt on my own. The spell I learned is Alohomora. It will open magically locked things, but don't get into
again terrible broomstick. Like, for what reason?
This is a symbol for Alohomora. When I stop, hold down the mouse button and make the same pattern, then let go of the button. Good, but I know you can do even better. Great, Harry. I'm sure Professor Flitwick would give you 5 house points for that charm. Practice makes perfect, so give it another go. I think you need to practice more on your own.
Super shit to split again. I'm losing time here.
Now you try using Alohomora. We still have a few minutes before the charms lesson. That door in front of you is magically locked. Cast Alohomora to open it.
Okay, I will.
Alohomora!
You've got it. Now, can you find the 2 secrets in this room?
Alohomora!
If you're done admiring yourself, Harry, take a look at that magical chest. Cast Alohomora to unlock it.
Alohomora! Alohomora! Alohomora!
Lupendo! Charms class is through this door.
Lupendo! Lupendo!
Welcome, young wizards. I am Professor Flitwick, and today you will learn the levitation spell Wingardium Leviosa. Observe the correct Wingardium Leviosa symbol. When I stop, hold down the mouse button and follow the pattern, then release the button.
Wingardium Leviosa!
That's good for a first year, Mr. Potter. 5 points for Gryffindor. Try going slightly faster this time. Do pay attention, Mr. Potter. That's not what I taught you. You may now enter the Wingardium Leviosa challenge to practice the spell. Follow me, Mr. Potter. Cast Wingardium Leviosa on that statue, then move it onto that large plate.
Wingardium Leviosa!
Well done! Now go and collect the challenge stars. I'll meet you at the end. Good luck, Mr. Potter.
Wingardium Leviosa! Wingardium Leviosa! Wingardium Leviosa!
Fuck!
Wingardium Leviosa!
Come on. No. For fuck's sake. I don't even want to play this game anymore. Why the fuck is this happening?
You're ugly, but what can we do?
Hey, Harry, do you have 25 beans for us? We need the beans for some nice work, Harry. In fact, all the beans we need for now. Here's a wizard card, then. Hope you don't have this one yet.
If you look in a mirror, it surely will crack.
Thanks for helping us out, Harry.
Young Potter, you're ugly, but what can we do?
Surprises. Malfoy's got a present for you. Better watch your step around here, Potter. Everybody Slytherins don't like the Gryffindors.
If you look at me, Nintendo!
Well, well, Potter, we meet again. Having a tour of the castle, are we?
Young Potter, you're ugly,
this is as far as you'll be going. You won't get past me, no matter how hard you try.
Potter, and you better watch out.
Oh, boo hoo! Potter can't get out of the castle.
Everyone says you belong in a zoo.
These wizard crackers should make you feel better. They're surprisingly good fun. Here, catch!
Over here.
Not that bad.
Harry, it's me, Hagrid. Good to see you. These are the Hogwarts Castle
grounds,
and I'm the gamekeeper, of course. Can't believe how quickly everything grows round here. Your friend Hermione's at the entrance to the greenhouse waiting for you. Drop round for tea later, after your lessons are done.
Fuck! Fucking hell.
Thanks for helping us out, Harry. Here's a wizard card then. Hope you don't have this one yet. Come on, George. We've got work to do.
Welcome, class. I am Professor Sprout. Today we'll learn the Incendio spell, which is useful against all manner of dangerous plants. Observe the correct Incendio symbol. Hold down the mouse button and follow the pattern. Then release the button.
Incendio!
Good work, Mr. Potter. You have great potential. 5 points for Gryffindor. Try to go a little bit quicker this time. Whatever the spell is you're attempting, it's not Incendio. Now it's time for the Incendio challenge. Through the doors, Mr. Potter. I'll watch you from the balcony. Those are spiky bushes. You may cast Incendio on them, but step back to avoid their needles.
Incendio! Incendio! Crependo! 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 Crependo!
This is a typical species of venomous tentacular. Cast Incendio to wilt it.
Incendio!
Good work! Now collect the challenge stars to complete your lesson. Away you go!
Attacking that poor tree. That looks like a doxy. Ouch!
Lipendo! Lipendo! Lipendo!
Those vines look dangerous. I think they look stepping off.
Incendio! Lipendo!
Here comes Neville. He looks quite upset. Best go and see what he wants.
Please help me.
So Longbottom has gone snivelling to you, and you want me to give you his precious remembrall. I think I'll leave it somewhere for Longbottom to collect. How about up a tree? Think you can catch me? Come on then, Potter.
Give me back Neville's Remember-All, Malfoy.
You want the Remember-All back? See if you can catch it. And you better watch out for my bludgers!
Typical. Just fucking typical.
Potter, you'll pay for this. Here, take this stupid thing. I've no use for it.
remember all about it. Thanks, Harry. I'll be able to find my toad now. Come here, Trevor. Come back. I remember now. I left Trevor near the herbology class. There are plants there that eat toads.
Mr. Potter, I'm Professor McGonagall, Deputy Headmistress of Hogwarts and Head of Gryffindor House. Although I do not approve of your chasing Malfoy about, I'll admit you have remarkable talent on a broomstick. Ordinarily, first-year students may not compete in Quidditch. In your case, we might overlook that rule. Harry, Gryffindor's first Quidditch match of the year is later this afternoon against the formidable Slytherin team. See you then.
Oh, well, fuck. God damn it. Like, stupid shit like that. I fucking hate it.
What?
Fuck. Sake. Jesus, I nearly fell down. That was bad. That was bad.
Over here. Come along then. I've something to show you. Now. By the way, congratulations on making the Quidditch team. Word travels fast round Hogwarts. Welcome to my home, Harry. It's small, but still roomier than your cupboard under the stairs, eh? Now I can show you what I wanted to talk to you about. It's a dragon's egg, Harry. But it's our secret, mind you. The egg is at a very delicate stage. I can't leave it here alone, but I need some fire seeds to give it that last burst of heat to make it hatch. Harry, can you fetch me some fire seeds? I grow them in caves out in the garden.
I need you to collect as many fire seeds as you can find. Careful though, they're spitting fire and the seeds are hot. Let them cool down before you pick them up.
Fuck
off you go then.
No, fuck. How did I?
That must be a fire seed.
I love this.
Hagrid told me to stay away from the hot seeds. Flipendo.
Thank you.
Great work, Harry. You've collected all the fire seeds I need. Here's a wizard card for you from my own collection. Come on inside, Harry. Wipe your feet now. Go ahead and put them in the fire, Harry. You've done it, Harry. It's hatching. Ain't he lovely? I'll call him Morven. He's a Norwegian ridgeback, you know. You come, me beauty. Thanks, Harry. Here, take this flute. It can be used to help some creatures sleep. You'd best get ready for Quidditch now. Should be an exciting game. Slytherin's a tough team, but you'll show 'em, eh? We'd better give Norbert his first feed soon.
Fucking shit, dude.
I'm your commentator, Lee Jordan. It's Gryffindor versus Slytherin. The Quidditch pitch has three goals at each end. The chasers throw the coffle and try to put it through the hoops to score. Watch out for the bludgers. These are charm balls that can knock you off your broomstick. 2 meters of each team shot to keep them away. Gryffindor's new team seeker is Harry Potter. It's his job to find and catch the golden snitch.
Jordan, no favoritism.
Sorry, miss. Remember, first avoid the bludgers, then find and catch the snitch. The game is over when the snitch is caught. Good luck.
If I don't fuck up.
Let's play Quidditch! A glint of gold? Is that the snitch? Here comes Potter! Potter's gaining! Yeah. He caught it! Maximum points for Gryffindor! Potter's done it! Gryffindor have beaten Slytherin! Well done, Harry Potter! My name's Lee Jordan, signing off.
Harry Potter, the youngest seeker in the history of Hogwarts, had won the Quidditch match.
Congratulations again for winning the Quidditch match against Slytherin. You are fantastic. Something is troubling me, Harry. Ron and I heard strange noises outside the Forbidden Corridor. Come up to the third floor and have a look.
Just read in the Daily Prophet that Gringotts, the wizard bank, has been broken into. I wonder who'd do that.
Hey, Harry, have you collected 25 beans? Thanks, Harry. We really needed these. They're for a little joke we're playing on Slytherin. Here's a wizard card for you. You've earned it. Come on, George. We've got work to do.
Fucking hell. I did lose some time.
You may begin the Lumos challenge to practice the spell. Follow me, Mr. Papata. Hold down the mouse button to aim the spell. To cast Lumos, let go of the button. You may practice on that gargoyle. That's quite bright, isn't it? Now you can cross the chasm and collect your challenge stars. I'll meet you at the end.
Fucking hell! shit, dude. No, you fucked this game, dude. I have no idea what the fuck just happened. Frankly, I didn't even care.
Harry? Have you collected 25 beans? We need the beans for some experiment. Nice work, Harry. You found all the beans we needed for now. Here's a wizard card then. Hope you don't have this one yet. Remember, you don't know anything about us collecting beans. It'll be our secret, right?
Gryffindor, you're quite tenacious, aren't you?
Next is our potions lesson, and it looks like we're already late.
Your potions teacher, Professor Snape. Today, you will learn how to mix a Wiganweld healing potion. You're late for potions, Mr. Potter. Inexcusable.
We need a piss.
5 points from Gryffindor. Potter, go to the dungeons and fetch the potion ingredients for the class. Bring back Wigan tree bark, moly, dittany, and flubberworm mucus. Be quick about it, or I shall deduct house points from Gryffindor. Now be gone, and don't come back without the ingredients.
That must be dittany. I wonder if Snape tricked me.
Dr. Martin told me. I think that... Bloody Baron.
Oh, what's with the fucking thing?
Flipendo!
That must be dissonant.
Late again, you lazy boy. A further 3 points from Gryffindor should teach you a lesson. I see you've collected a few challenge stars, but I'm afraid they have no value in my classroom. I've ended the lesson without you, Potter. The other students are off to the Halloween feast. Join them, if you must.
Is on the rampage. It's cornered Hermione in the girls' bathroom. She needs our help. We must try to rescue her straight away.
Harry, what's that smell?
This way, Harry!
Saving me? Is he dead?
I think he's just been knocked out.
Come on, let's get out of here.
Exhausted from their encounter with the troll, Harry, Ron, and Hermione return to the Gryffindor common room and discuss the strange goings-on at Hogwarts. Harry suspected that someone had released the troll to distract everyone so that they could get into the Forbidden Corridor. But there wasn't much time to think about who was behind this, especially since Harry was busy preparing for the second Quidditch match against Ravenclaw.
Up! Welcome to Quidditch! I'm your commentator, Lee Jordan! It's Gryffindor versus Ravenclaw! Let's play Quidditch! A glint of gold? Is that the snitch? Potter sees the snitch! Dodges a speeding Roger! Amazing skill! Potter's moving in! Roger! A near miss of Potter! Ooh, that was close! Gryffindor wins again! My name's Lee Jordan, signing off!
Thanks to Harry's skill as a seeker, Gryffindor won the Quidditch match against Ravenclaw. Harry, Ron and Hermione spent most of their free time in Hagrid's hut, trying to convince him that he couldn't keep Norbert, his beloved dragon. Eventually, after much coaxing, Hagrid agreed. Harry unwrapped the unexpected Christmas present. Something fluid and silvery slithered out. It's an invisibility cloak, said Ron. They're very rare. There was a note with the cloak. Your father left this in my possession, Harry read. Use it well. A very Merry Christmas to you. Harry tried on the cloak, while Ron and Hermione helped him prepare for the climb up the tower. Be careful, Harry, said Hermione. You can't stay invisible while you cast spells. Filch might see you. With Norbert safely bundled up, Harry set off for the tallest tower. He hoped that the cloak would conceal him from Filch and his cat, Mrs. Norris.
What's that?
Where are you, you sneaky slime? I'll catch you. Yes, I will. Intruder! Intruder! In the Forbidden Corridor!
Now, how can I get up there?
Pray I don't find you, my stealthy little student.
Oh,
slime. I'll catch you. Yes, I will. You, and when I do, you'll regret it.
Ron's brother, Charlie, had arranged to collect the dragon from the tower and return him to Romania.
heard you for sure this time. Quick, Mrs. Norris, you keep watch from above. You'll not get past me now, you rotten little gutter snipes. Intruder!
Reflected in the mirror of Erised were Harry's parents, James and Lily Potter. Harry stared hungrily back as though hoping to fall right through the glass and reach them, startled when a voice sounded behind him. Harry turned slowly about. So you, like hundreds before you, have discovered the delights of the mirror of Erised, said Professor Dumbledore. He went on to explain that the mirror showed nothing more or nothing less than the deepest, most desperate desire of our hearts, but that it would give neither knowledge nor truth. The mirror of Erised will be moved to a new home shortly, Dumbledore went on, adding ominously that if Harry ever came across it again, he would be prepared. But prepared for what? Thought Harry.
Filthy whelps gave us the slip, Mrs. Norris. I've locked the only door out of here for the sake of me nerves. Stay here and watch the library for a bit, my dear. The only way out of this room is past that gate. It makes an awful racket. You take that side of the room, and I'll take this one. We'll catch you, Mrs. Norris. Intruder!
What's that?
Intruder! Come out, wherever you are.
come Piper. Fucking insane times.
Hey Harry, do you find beans for us? That's it! That's all the beans we need! Thanks, Harry. We couldn't have done it without you. Here's a wizard card for you. You've earned it. Thanks, Harry. We really needed these. Remember, you don't know anything about us collecting beans. It'll be our secret, right? Come on, George. We've got work to do.
And Harry researched the secret of the Sorcerer's Stone.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Elixir of life, a potion that would make anyone immortal. No wonder someone's trying to get it. Anyone would want it, said Harry. Hermione suspected that the package Hagrid had taken from Gringotts contained the Sorcerer's Stone. It was the Sorcerer's Stone that was down the Forbidden Corridor, being guarded by whatever it was that had growled at them.
Snape's been acting very suspicious lately. He may be planning to steal the Sorcerer's Stone.
But there's no way Snape would try anything while Dumbledore's around.
Dumbledore left 10 minutes ago for the Ministry of Magic in London.
That must mean that tonight's the night. Let's go!
What about Filch? He's always watching the Forbidden Corridor.
We'll just have to take our chances then.
It looks like Filch is somewhere else tonight. Come on, let's go!
This way, Harry!
I think this is where the growling has been coming from.
Hear that? I don't think we should go in there.
This run is a free world record,
though. But we've got to
stop Snape! So, whatever.
Go on, Harry. We're right behind you.
With no fuck-ups, this run is indeed a free world record.
Only Hagrid would call this monster Fluffy.
I'll try the flute. That might put Fluffy to sleep for a while. Do be careful!
To go first, Hermione?
No, I don't.
Right.
See you in a minute, I hope. It's okay! It's a soft landing! You can jump!
Come on, Harry! I know what this is. It's the devil's snare.
Next time I'm going to pay more attention in herbology.
Help! It's a devil's snare!
Try not to get too close to those tentacles.
Guys, the key first and all that stuff, and we should be good.
That was close, Harry.
This way, Harry.
You have to catch the key, Harry. Time to put your Quidditch skills to practice.
Whoa, but I catch the key. Oh.
Let's see what this is.
Much faster than previously.
The next puzzle is a gigantic chessboard. Bron's gone through to play. I hope he's all right. Walk onto the board, Harry, to start the game. Oh, Ron, are you all right?
I've defeated most of the pieces, but I've been hurt. It's up to you now, Harry.
Harry, you have to be careful and avoid the pieces. They all move one square at a time.
Is she?
Have to make the pieces fight each other in order to get across safely. Walk onto the board, Harry, to start the game. Do be careful. Come on, let's go!
wondered whether I'd be meeting you here, Potter. I suppose you were expecting someone else. Well, it's me, scared, stuttering Professor Quirrell. You're far too inquisitive to remain among the living. Curses, Potter!
Ah.
You will not succeed again. Give me the stone.
No, that's the most free world record I've seen in my life.
Please speak to him face to face.
Master, you're not strong enough.
I have strength enough for this.
No, you... I died stupidly. I can do it, I can do it. Come on, don't choke. Don't choke here. Not like this. Choke.
Wow. He has the stone.
Give me the stone.
Let me speak to him face to face.
I'm actually choking right now.
Master, you're not strong enough.
I have strength enough for this.
Escape me. Maybe I can cast a pendant on the
Come on, you fucking people. Why is this guy such a piece of shit? Why is this guy such a bullshit? You're 136. Man, if I didn't fuck up that.
Dumbledore smiled. What happened?